the economic impact and the health impact of this could justify it and increase the demand for more money going into it.
I could live with the emissions, not just monitoring.
Yeah.
And providing sense of mobile sensors.
Right. In some sense, just knowing what it is only the first step of the story, right?
Correct.
Unless we actually do something about it, and that's why I mentioned that earlier, you know, can we get our politicians to better understand? Can we get the citizenry to better understand? Can we get the legislators to better understand? And all of those things are going to be terribly important if we're going to make a significant difference.
They make policy choices on what data they have or what they understand at the time. They apparently don't have a lot of good data.
So I'm hosting a regional, statewide, in Texas, air quality science for solutions conference. And the next, this year's 2018 conference is March 29th. And so that's off the coast of April 2nd. But for a longer term view, that is going to be, there'll be an entire day where you will have representatives from pretty much every air quality organization, laboratory, government agency, industry, will all be in one room on the Beaver State campus in April 29th. And so people like Randy
March 20th,
they're producing, Randy's got these little small sensors he's been slowly producing over the years, hasn't quite optimized yet. Carrie's got her Lego sensors that we're talking about. John Morrell at the Atmospheric Sciences Department at U of U, they've been flying these little small songs that are in a coffee cup, just a styrofoam cup that are a couple of bucks. And so lots of different groups are making small sensor systems that are all independent. There's no coordination. But then on the other hand, the same group of people twice now, we've done large scale coordinations, three times. One was mentioned, I think it was you mentioned, Twin Otter and NOAA. I was just meeting that today. And so this group does work together well. And so there is the potential for having a nucleus of people here from USU, BYU, Beaver State, USU, Vernal, Albert, and all traffic. All these agencies have already worked together with the Department of Air Quality closely. So it would be fairly reasonable to try and coordinate something.
And I think it would be a great thing to be able to aggregate that data, be able to do meta-analysis, via visualization.
You need to do the programming for the visualization.
Right. And I think the programming and the visualization is kind of right down the line of what I can put. So maybe we're part of your project and you're part of our project. And if the Picos can go and help out with this,
yeah.
Inside a baseball, so we'll put it back and forth to measure it.
Yeah, certainly. I think Picos would be great. I mean, you mentioned having expensive sensors, calibrating cheaper sensors. I can perfectly imagine Picos being the software that drives them.
Get together all of these resources that we've got, both here in the room and those who forgot to come today, and do something that's going to really make a very significant difference. And I'm very proud to be part of the visualization because I think the visualization is what will actually help the leaders understand what's really going on.
So are you local? So
I am
not local, right?
He's actually at the University of Utah. And I work?
Okay, so you are based here now.
Yes, I
actually live in Capitol
Hill. And I live here in Lehigh. Poster or a
conference. To, I put it up in my poster, which is the same place.
I mean, Kansas City. So anyway, poster deadline's passed, but I'm a webmaster, so I can stick the poster in there and run on it. And so we can stick the poster in. And so if somebody would like to pull that together, if you would like to, BYU and the PICO lab would like to, kind of be the center point, or someone like to take that, in as that bull by the horns, you can, I will make room for a poster for you to present at the meeting. We'll have health scientists, modelers. It's a very broad spectrum of air quality.
I'm pretty well tied into the big data community, and we have a number of different user group communities, so that if there's interest there from an attendance standpoint, I'd be more than glad to digitally push the message as well. So let's exchange information before we meet.
We can push things out on our network as well, and then everything snaps in the network.
So if we could get somebody to say, yep, I'll take the lead of organizing this into a poster and carrying the gospel forward, vision, I'm more than happy to put you right in the middle of the test collection of our scientists that you're applying.
Is it better if we push the date back from April 2nd a little bit further after that conference?
Well, you're not going to be able to get much response from that particular group. I'm presuming that this is not a one-shot ban and it disappears.
Yeah.
And so the main miss for this year would give people a chance to start thinking long-term and how they might be able to leverage the capabilities and vision by this organization with what their needs are.
We're about out of time unless any other comments or questions. Well, that was a great discussion. Hopefully give our overview and expectations and what we're looking for. We'll push the video out as well so we can share the discussion. And if there's no other comments, we'll...
Thanks for organizing. Awesome job.
Thanks.